In today's episode of Bike Fit Tuesdays, we're going over stance. What is stance and how does it affect your riding? We're also going to cover how you can adjust it because there's multiple ways of doing so.
So stance is probably one of the most overlooked aspects of bike fitting. And I think it creates a huge amount of problems for most of my customers. And I think we need to talk about how bicycle design has progressed or regressed over the last few years. So with the advent of press fit bottom brackets, two-piece chain sets, historically bikes were threaded bottom bracket and three-piece chain sets, there has been a move from in the bike industry to reduce the width of the bottom bracket and the stance width and actually the overall Q factor of the bicycle. This is mostly to aid pedaling through corners. Now, what we're going to consider is that a vast majority of people who are riding bicycles aren't racing them. And again, this is yet another testament to bike manufacturers designing bicycles for professional racing and not designing them for the end user. A lot of people talk about Q factor. Q factor is the distance between the cranks. When I say stance, I'm talking about the human being and how far apart their feet are. It's the distance of how far apart their feet are. I think the first way of thinking about it is just to think about the rider physiology. So I'm finding an increasing need for a lot of my customers to increase the stance. And this is usually driven by, rider physiology. So you've got a larger rider, a taller rider, a broader rider, they're almost always going to need more stance, get the feet further apart and further away from the bicycle. And there are a number of ways of doing this. Some individuals possess physiological traits that require wider stance. So tibial varum, which is or bow-leggedness, and actually tibial varum is relatively common, it's a bowing of the tibias, the largest bone below the knee, and riders I'm coming to find that possess this physiological trait almost always need either an axial extension or increased stance. So if it's too narrow, it can potentially cause a lot of problems. So a very common problem is foot pain, and what happens is essentially, when the feet are too close together, you actually end up driving to the outside of the shoe. So what it leads to is pressure along the lateral aspect of the foot, usually in both feet. And this tends to lead people to think they need to go and buy wide-fitting shoes. This discomfort on the outside of the foot, if it builds over time, it's possibly your stance. If it's in one foot, it's probably because your saddle's too high, because it runs too high. If it's in both feet, it's very likely that it's the stance and the feet are too close together. But if it's something that you feel straight away as soon as you put your shoe on, it could be the fit of the shoe. Ultimately, though, I think with regards to stance, you can end up with putting pressure on the outside of the foot. Secondly, medial knee pain on the inside of the knee is commonly associated with insufficient stance. There are also saddle ramifications, so it usually creates an asymmetric interaction with the saddle. And we found this through pressure mapping. You increase the stance and actually it dramatically improves the interaction with the saddle. And then finally, the pressure on one's hands can also be influenced. So quite often I'll increase the stance, pressure on the hands almost disappears. Too wide is less common, but if you think about if you are quite a petite rider, riders with valgus knees, sorry, knock knee, they quite often need
a drill.
If your stance is too wide, it could develop iliotibial band-esque symptoms, so discomfort on the outside of the leg or the outside of the knee. Generally speaking, I tend not to come across that too often, but again, if you've got smaller individuals, more slender individuals, valgus knee individuals, so individuals with knock knees, tend to need a narrower stance, but I would say the insufficient stance is much more common. The easiest way, and least expensive way, is do it at the cleat. Now, I must iterate that this is actually quite counterintuitive for a lot of people. I remember in BikeFit 101 learning this and just thinking, that doesn't make any sense. But basically what we're looking to do is we want to get the foot away from the bike. So what we're going to do actually is we're going to push it So this is a right shoe. The best way to describe it is you want to push the cleat underneath the ball of the foot. We're looking to space the foot away from the bike. So push it over to one side.
Assuming you want to go wider.
This is assuming you want to go wider, yeah. If you want to go narrow, obviously go the other way around. That's one of the quickest and easiest ways of increasing your stance, and it can pay dividends. I quite often have customers that come in here and their stance is minimized, so it's as narrow as it can be. I move it to the max and it makes a big difference. The other way to do it is with washers. I actually use these a lot. This is a 1.5 millimeter pedal washer. It's actually specifically designed for bike fit application. I recently made a bit of a blunder and I had some custom 2 millimeter pedal washers made. They don't work because the cretins that made them did them wrong. Anyway, so that is a relatively inexpensive way to go about increasing the stance. You can only really use one of these
because you're reducing the amount of thread.
You're reducing the amount of thread in the crank. So in the only exception to that is the Lux system, which has a slightly longer axle, because the Lux are they are intended to be used with a 2 millimeter space that you can buy from Lux. And then finally, there is a pedal system. There are a number of different pedal systems that are wider / narrower. It's worth noting that the Dura Ace pedal from Shimano is narrower than the Altegra 105, R550, so on and so forth. Every other pedal in the range is wider than the Dura Ace, and that's included in the long axle version. So Shimano also makes a long axled version pedal, 4 millimeter increase. This long axle pedal is my best selling pedal system at a rate of about 50 to 1 on the grounds that most consumers tend to need a wider, not most consumers, but a lot of consumers tend to need a little wider stance in a realm where the stance is always being reduced. It's also worth noting that, so Look doesn't make a long axle version of any of their pedals, but they do have a slightly longer thread cut into them, which allows you to use more spaces. Speedplay also offers a selection of different axle lengths, which you can custom order. At this point in time, they aren't currently available in the UK. It's also worth noting that if you're looking at pedal-based power meters, they almost all have an increased stance. And this is something that actually really irritates me, because they allude on their websites that it doesn't influence your fit or your biomechanics. But I can tell you, it absolutely categorically does. If you're one of the latter individuals, the smaller individuals with a valgus knee, or you're a petite woman, don't buy a pedal-based power meter. It's probably going to cause you problems. I think we also need to talk about wedging and how stance influences knee tracking. So historically, if you've got someone who is knock-kneed, Bike Fitting 101 tells you to put a wedge in there to straighten the knee. When I say wedge, I'm talking about something like this, cleat wedge, which goes between the shoe and the cleat and counts the whole shoe, or something like this, even worse, that goes in between the footbed and the inside of the shoe, which counts the forefoot. These products are intended to improve knee alignment. I'm not saying they don't, but I find that stance is a much more effective way of improving knee alignment, and I think these are very effective when used correctly. I use forefoot wedging almost never, because I tend to find forefoot correction tends to cause issues. So that's just one other thing. I think stances are just a very effective way of optimizing. I mean, you ultimately want to get, it's a stacking exercise to get the foot underneath the knee, underneath the hip. In conclusion, I think the best way to set stance really is to consider your morphology. Consider, how you're anatomically laid out. If you're slender and skinny, narrower stance. If you're broad, wide, or if you have tight hips, wider stance.
So there you go, that is stance width. If you want to experiment, do. It's very, very cheap. Well, actually, free adjustment if you're fiddling around with your cleats. As usual, big thank you for watching today's video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Leave any questions down below, and me and James will do our best to answer them. And if you want to book a fit with James, I'll leave a link down below in the description as well. Thank you, and see you soon.